Ladies and gentlemen, this is Joe's Classic Video Games back with another cool pinball repair for you today. Today we are all Williams. We are working on this old school Pat Hand pinball machine from 1975, it says. And we have been working through this bad boy. So we did a video where we worked down in the bottom of it, which I'm now calling the coffin. And then we did a video where we worked through the back box back behind the panel with all the electronics back there. And then we did a video where we worked on the underside of the playfield. And at the end of the last video, we had got the ball, the game, to work a little bit. But we're now to the point where we're going to work on the playfield. So this particular machine is a... it's fairly sparse. There's not a lot on it. There's very few rubber rings even. But it's a very fun game. You'll see whenever we finally get it up and running. But it's got some issues on the playfield. So we're going to strip it all down, clean it all up, and then we have a couple things that we have to mess with. So the first thing that we have to do is we have to repaint a little bit of it. So we're going to do a little bit of touch-up paint there. Shouldn't be that big of a deal. And then, are you ready to disagree with me? If you're ready to disagree with me, we have to talk about these pop bumpers. And there's a freaking fly on the pop bumper. How did we get a fly in here? We have these two pop bumpers down here at the bottom. This is an interesting layout on this machine, but they have some fairly severe wear right there around the skirts, which you see from time to time, but here's what happened. That wore down over the course of several years to the point where it, you know, dug a groove in the playfield there where the paint's gone. Well, that can be fixed. It could be repainted, but at some point, 10 or 15 years ago, I would guess, somebody took some Mylar stickers and stuck Mylar around the pop bumper. Over. Woo! I forgot we were in the middle of a game. This is why you get the end of the exciting gameplay, people. I mean, the exciting videos from us. Look, I'm so flustered, I can't even talk. Somebody stuck Mylar on the playfield on top of the wear, and they didn't even clean it before they did it. Look how dirty that crap is. So they didn't clean it, and then they put Mylar over it. Now, if you're a pinball guy, you'll say, well, that's fine, just take the Mylar off. And I'll say, have you ever taken Mylar off a really old playfield? I didn't say, have you taken Mylar off of an Adams Family, or have you taken Mylar off of a Stern, Terminator 3. Have you taken one off a really old playfield? It doesn't work, man. You can't get it off. You can heat it up, and you can freeze it. You need to get the glue to release, but it just makes the biggest mess ever, and it lifts paint all the way around whenever you pull it off. So, because they stuck Mylar on it, I don't even know why they did it. So, why would you put that Mylar on there? To keep it from getting any worse, right? Which means to keep the cosmetics from getting any worse, because it doesn't affect the play. It just means it doesn't chip as much paint. But by putting it on there with it dirty and not touching up the paint, you made it where it can't get any better either. You know, I can't repaint it because the Mylar's in the way. So what I'm going to do is, here's the part you're going to disagree with. I've ordered some Mylar that's opaque. So I'm going to stick a sticker on top of the sticker to cover it all up. So we'll be doing that later. If you don't like that kind of stuff, turn off the video now. But we'll see how that turns out. Hopefully that'll be a good solution for that. They basically, by putting the Mylar over the wear, they made it where I can't fix it. If I try to peel that crap off, it's going to pull all the paint up. And then I'm going to have glue stuck all over it. And so then to get the glue off, I have to pull up even more paint. Just, what a mess. Now on a newer machine, it's not that big of a deal. It's easier to take off. So the first thing we're going to do, people, is I'm going to take everything off of the playfield, get it down to bare wood and a few little pieces of metal sticking up. and then we'll clean it. Clean, clean, clean. And then once we get it cleaned, we'll see if we can make it look even better. So the way we clean it, you have to keep in mind these things are filthy. This thing's been sitting a long time. So look at the dirt. And that's ground down into the paint on the playfield. So normally you wouldn't want to get these really wet because it can make the wood swell and the paint planking happen and all of that. But we're filthy people. I mean, this is like really bad. So I'm literally going to spray it down with 409. I'm not going to go crazy with the 409, but I'm going to get it wet with 409. And then I'm going to wipe it down and get all of this crap off of it that I can. And then I'm going to hit it with a magic eraser and some rubbing alcohol. And I'm going to lightly clean it with magic eraser. Now, people say, oh, magic eraser's like sandpaper. Yeah, that's the point. You're sanding off all of the freaking wear and grime. And it's the only thing that will get down into these little cracks. The reason it looks so bad is because there are little cracks all in the paint. Let me get real close if it'll let me. Right there. Right in the center of the screen. Do you see the black marks? Those are little swirls and cracks in the paint. That's why it looks so bad. You can clean, clean, clean that, and that will not go away. So you use a magic eraser, and it's that stuff is made of... is it called it's not melamine, it's melamine foam, something like that. It's a certain type of foam that's very, very small, and it can get way down inside those little cracks that you're looking at. And so when it does that, it gets all the dirt out, cleans it up, and yeah, it sands it a little bit. But you don't go crazy with it, don't go nuts, very lightly, and it'll clean that crap right off. Makes it look great. It's a secret. It's a miracle foam. It's a magic eraser. It magically erases dirt. It's not just some product. It's like an actual, I mean, it's not some commercial thing. It's an actual type of foam that works really good for this. So we're going to hit it with that and make it look nice again. But we've got that wear area up there that we're going to repaint in this video. You're fortunate enough to be here to see us do it. So I'll set up the tripod and we'll start taking all this stuff off. It won't take long because there's not much there. This is what we're starting with. Everything looks pretty good. Whenever you see this kind of stuff, Those are rat trails. Rats have been in this at some point. Not uncommon, though. Just about every game you'll find that in. All in all, to be honest, the thing's in pretty good shape. Obviously, our issue is there. And then those pop bumpers, I wish they would have never put the Mylar on them, because I could have repainted those suckers right in and made them look brand new. But we got to do what we got to do. So, it's magic eraser time. I'm going to magically erase it. But the first step, though, is I'm going to just see how much of it I can get off by hand. So, let me clean it up a little bit and see what we end up with. Okay, so here's all what I was able to clean up with just pretty much a light cleaning. You can see how a lot of the wear is still there. This isn't like an apples to apples comparison, though, because whenever you wax it, it actually cleans it too. Wax can actually remove dirt, but you see a lot of the stuff is still there. It's kind of hard to get off. Also, you can use Novus. Novus is a product that a lot of pinball people use. I don't know if they made it specifically for pinballs, but it's a polish, and it's kind of the same thing. It's just a liquid that is abrasive. So depending on the level of Novus that you use, you can clean things up, and it polishes as it goes too. So Novus is good. Nothing wrong with that. Some people use Wildcat Playfield cleaner too. These magic erasers, I'm telling you, are amazing. So I'm going to show you. I'm going to work a little bit of it and just show you what they do. We'll work that spot up there at the top, and you can just see how it is. And it basically you are eating away a little teeny bit of the top of the playfield. So if you do it, do it light. Don't go crazy with it. So that's all I did, was I hit it with the magic eraser. But look what's going on. See how there are little spots and stuff here and there now? If you look at, like, over here, there's a little bit of that. I didn't do that yet. But look how where I did it. There's a little more of it. And then you can't really see it. You got to be very cognizant of this. It's kind of hard to even explain. If you look right here, as compared to right here, I got on this more because it was so dirty. Do you see how the color is lighter here than there? These playfields, they yellow as time goes on. It's just something in the paints and stuff, they just get yellow. It may even be the varnish, like the clear coat that's over it. If you're good with color, if you look at this, the entire playfield has kind of a yellow tint over it. It's hard to even, if you can't see colors very well, you may not notice it, but everything is a little bit too yellow. There's a yellow kind of tint over the entire playfield. And so what's going on here is, that stuff, like I said, is pretty much like sandpaper. So I have sanded through the top, whatever the yellowed part is, down to the original kind of color. So you can see that it's lighter, but over here you got more of a yellow going on. So it, whenever you get on it, if you go too much, you'll start getting color variances. You can see it a little bit up here too. So you got to use it as a tool. It's not going to fix it and make everything perfect, but you see it got rid of most of that wear. Now once we get the other things back on, get a lot of nice wax on here, you won't even hardly see anywhere, even though it's there. You know, it'll look just fine. But you can see, you can't go nuts with it. Just do it a little bit. you would be very tempted to keep going right there, but you're not going to get all that off, and what's going to happen is eventually you will start seeing white because you'll get down to the white paint under it. So don't do that, okay? So do about that much, and then you're done. I can't do any more there. That's as good as it's going to get. But I'll keep touching this up and then work all the other spots, and we'll see how it turns out. So when you're done with the magic eraser, you will have white stuff all over the playfield where you have basically broke up that foam all over everything. So then you have to clean that off too. So I'm going to wipe it down once again, and then we can see what we're starting with. But you can see how the wear is dirty there because I didn't clean it. And you see how the wear here, when I hit it, it's got it nice and white and light. See how the ball track that was all black earlier, now it's white. That's basically that dust is in there. Whenever you clean it, some of that will come off, but it should be, you know, it's basically, it looks like unstained wood, you know. That's what you're looking for if you get it clean. And most people, if they see wear like that, it, you know, they don't get this feeling in their mind that, oh, this thing's filthy, you know. So we're just trying to clean it up a little bit first, and then we'll do some paint. So I'll wipe off all this dust, and we'll see what we've got. So we've wiped it down now. This is what we're starting with. So we're going to touch that up, make it look a lot better. I may touch up down here too, these circles, but the problem is everywhere you touch up you have to clear coat, and I just spray the clear coat on out of a rattle can. So I hate to put little spots everywhere, but we'll see what we can do. Okay, so the very first thing that I do, we're going to match this paint. The very first thing I do is I take an acrylic paint pen, not a Sharpie. I did not say Sharpie. I said an acrylic paint pen, and I draw the lines back in. So like I draw that line back in, draw that line back in, draw that line back in, maybe touch a bit black or whatever. You got to watch though, you know, that's not actually a line. If you look, it's not black. So I draw in whatever lines there are. So there's not many, just a couple. 1, 2, 3. And by doing that, it kind of defines the area that you're trying to touch up. It makes it like a big coloring book, right? And so down here, you can take your same acrylic paint pen and just draw in the places that should be black. So I wouldn't put it down here, which would leave you with a little bit of wear there, like that. But what would it matter, right? So you're not trying to make it perfect, you're just trying to make it a little bit better than it is. The more you do to it, the more obvious it will be that it was touched up. So you're trying to do minimal things, people, minimal, minimal. But the you know, there's enough wear there that somebody's going to look at it and go, eh, it's a little worn. There's enough wear there, somebody's going to look at it and go, eh, it's a little worn. So we gotta do a little bit to it. This you could probably get away with, especially if nothing else was worn. But I'll probably touch it up. That one there's a little heavy. And if you do that one, you have to do that one, you know. So that's the whole thing. Once you do a little bit, you gotta just keep going. Which means that eventually you have to stop. So do I stop before I do this? Or do I just do that and stop? Or do I do that and this and stop? So we'll see. So I'll get the paint and the acrylic paint pen, and we'll draw those lines in real quick. Okay, so here's our acrylic paint pen. Somebody actually sent us these actual ones. Thank you, whoever did that. Modern Art Artistro Materials. So here's why you want it like it is, okay? Here's what you want. Water-based. So why can't you just use a Sharpie? It's because whenever you spray clear coat on it, it makes the Sharpie run. Like the whatever the stuff is in spray paint,
will mix with the stuff in the Sharpie, and it just makes the biggest freaking mess. You will see this circle just go all over the playfield. You will have a heart attack if you use a Sharpie and then spray paint over it. It's amazing. I probably should do it one day and just show you what it does. But if you use acrylic, it's just water-based paint. So you can put spray paint that's more of like it's not really oil-based paint, but it just has, you know, catalyst and stuff in the freaking spray. But it can go over water-based paint without making it run. The stuff stays right where it's supposed to be. And if you don't believe me, stay tuned. So I just took the thing and I went and I touched up all of the lines that you could see on those. So I didn't do this one. Now, why didn't I do that one? Because then I'd have to clear coat over there too. So I'm trying to just clear coat this spot. And then what we're working on up here, and I did these. So I'm trying to just be able to clear coat just parts of it instead of having to try to clear coat the whole freaking play field. Because I literally just spray it on with a spray paint can. So we put these lines back, just a couple of them. Now you can see once you do that, it kind of makes the art blend in where you don't notice as much that that the wear is there. So you're already making it better just by putting the lines back that are missing. Let me see who's calling us. They wanted an Xbox 360 controller. I told them to come on by. I've got plenty. Okay, so we got that inked in. I also did these four of them right here. I didn't do anything with this. Although we're going to have a little bit there. And I didn't do anything up there. A couple things people have asked about. People have asked about how do you get rid of this. You don't get rid of that. Not really a good way to do it. What's basically going on there is that the clear coat has been rubbed through because every time you shoot the ball, it goes the exact same area. It does the exact same thing because there's a arch there. So the ball's a ball. So just the one little part is actually touching the playfield, and it's rolling over the same exact part of the playfield every shot. And it just wears away the clear coat. So what you're looking at now that we've cleaned it is that's bare wood. So that's bare wood with no stain on it, and the rest of it is wood with stain on it. Once you wax it, it makes it look pretty good. I don't mess with it. Just leave it. Looks great. I don't have another one in here that we've done that I can show it. So, and people don't expect that not to be there. So it's not like, you know, if that bothers you that's there, it's just, come on people, what are you wanting? It's every game has that. So don't do anything with that. There was another question somebody had that I was going to mention. Maybe I'll think of it later. Okay, so the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to mix some of the colors. So this, if you think this is like a big deal, it's very complicated, it's really not. It's not all that big of a deal because the playfield doesn't really have that many colors on it. So we've got some wear in our blue here. So this light blue, I need to mix that so I can paint here and paint here. Okay. And then I've got like a, we'll call this burgundy, but it's kind of purplish burgundy. This burgundy here, which is also the same color as that's here. So that's two colors. And then when you've got this, we'll call this, what is that? Is that the famous fuchsia? So that might be fuchsia. Or what else could you call that? It's almost like a watermelon color. So we got to mix that for there, that little bit. And then if I wanted to, I could put a little bit of it down here too. It depends on how close the match is. If it's a perfect match, I'll do this. If you can see it at all, I won't do it because it'll look better with a little bit of wear than obviously being touched up a little bit wrong, right? But if it's up here, you won't notice it as much because you're standing way back here. So your eyeball is about right here. Know what I mean? But we got to mix that. And then we have to mix this light green. And that's it. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4. And that one's the same as this one. So I need to mix 4 paint colors, and it fixes all that. And I could also use it to fix this if I wanted.
So let's say you had to do stuff all over the playfield. Well, there's a darker green there, so that's 5. And that's it. There's 5 colors on the whole playfield, not counting black and not counting white. So it's not that complex. Easy peasy, people. Easy peasy. So we're going to use acrylic paint, and then of course we have to clear over it. So I've got this big box of paint that I've had for years. And so I went to make, you can go to Hobby Lobby, or you can go to Michael's. Y'all went with me one time. Remember, I went to Michael's and bought some. You go to Michael's and you buy this stuff. It's like 70 cents a bottle. Now, if you don't have a Michael's or a Hobby Lobby near you, just go online and order it. But it needs to be acrylic so that you can spray paint over it. Another good reason to have it acrylic is if you mess up, you can just wipe it off. Another good reason to have it acrylic, they mix really easy. So I've got this whole box of paint, all different colors and stuff. And whenever I get one that's a really good one, like my, where's my Razzleberry? There it is, Razzleberry. This stuff here fits everything. See what I'm saying? Do you see what I'm saying now? Do you see what I'm saying about the damn Razzleberry? Okay, so make sure you get some Razzleberry. And there are certain ones that you will use over and over and over and over and over again. But if you're off a little bit, you can mix them too. You just, the more you do it, the better you'll get with it, where you kind of understand how the color wheel works and stuff. But I guess we'll try the Razzleberry stuff first, see how close that is to what's on the playfield. And I'm just going to use a little paintbrush and paint a little bit of it on there. Just a little bit. And we'll see if it matches. Now, sometimes, too, if you have a big area, depending on how much you want to do it, I don't want to spend a ton of time on it because I sell them, you know. So I'm getting paid to do this. And the more time I spend working on it and running my mouth, the less I get paid. But I've figured out a way where I put videos on YouTube and then I get paid for the videos on YouTube, too. So, you know. It all works out for me, but for you, it might be different. And if you're doing it at your house, you may want to spend 30 hours working on this playfield because you want it to be really nice. Yeah, it's fine with me. So it just depends on how much you want to do. But what you could do if you wanted to get it just right is repaint the whole thing. If you repainted the whole thing, and you could use a frisking tape, I think that's called, and get it just perfect and take your time and do all kinds of stuff. I'm trying to do it in like 2 hours. I want to spend a couple hours on it and be done with it. And that way I kind of get my time investment back for what I sell it for. I sell most of these, like this particular one, we're going to sell probably, it's a little less desirable than some of the other ones just because it's a cool theme and all, but it's nothing, it's not super collectible like everybody's favorite game or something. So it's probably going to be about $1,300 or something like that when I'm done. And if I don't touch that up, I could probably still sell it for $1,300. That's just kind of where our business is at. We have a list of people that are looking for games and stuff, and most of them don't necessarily need the thing to be perfect. They're just, you know, looking to get a fun game that plays well. So I do have to get it where it works really good, but little stuff like that, it doesn't necessarily have to be done. Now, if I fixed that, and I fixed all this, and I took all this off, and I got those perfect and everything, and I took, you know, 4 or 5 hours to get all that mylar off and then repainted the whole area and did everything as nice as I could possibly get it and spent considerable more time, I still wouldn't be able to get more than about $1,300 for it. So it's kind of a thing where a lot of this work that I'm doing, I'm not really making my money back on it, but I just out of love for the game, you know, you got to get it respectable. So I have the ability to make this look a lot better. I'm going to go ahead and do it and spend a couple hours and make sure that we get it as nice as I could reasonably get it. So we'll do the Razzleberry first and see if that's close. I'll let it dry a little bit, and then if it's off significantly, we'll see if we can mix it with something else. So obviously Razzle Dazzle is a miracle paint. Look, perfect, right out of the bottle. Razzle Dazzle, people. I mean Razzleberry. Razzleberry. It's a miracle paint. Where's this stuff made? Oh, it's made in England. No, it's made in the USA.
Deco art is from the UK, but it's made in the USA, which is why they call it Americana. It was 99 cents when I got it at Hobby Lobby, damn near 10 years ago. But they're always on sale, too, so there's like 20% off or something. Oh, look, it was made in Kentucky. Stanford, Kentucky. To all you bluegrass people out there. All right, so I'm getting low. We better go order a bunch. This stuff, since it's just perfect right out of the bottle for all kinds of machines, we ought to order a whole ton of it, right? So it's 91 cents at Hobby Lobby, and I'm trying to order 455 bottles of it. But it keeps telling me they've only got 13 of them. We're sorry, we don't have the requested quantity available in stock. I'm going to have to call them. Okay, so for our next color stunt, I matched the... What color would you say that is, Matt?
Spoiled peach?
He calls it spoiled peach. It's that color right there. Now, it's not perfect. Actually, it looks pretty damn good, doesn't it?
I think you nailed it.
So we kind of got there. Luckily, it's just a little spot. And so what I did was, see, I've got paint all over my fingers. I kept mixing it back and forth, with all these different freaking colors. So this one is pretty close out of the coral blush. It's pretty close out of the bottle, but it's too bright and light. So I darkened it up with our good old Razzleberry. What do you think about the name Razzleberry, Matt?
They couldn't license
it. It's right up your alley, isn't it?
I just think they couldn't license the name Raspberry.
Okay. Raspberry has a copyright?
I don't know.
I think you're full of it. Okay, so we put that in, and that got it kind of And then Matt suggested orange. So I went a little orange, and then I tried to darken it with black. But as you know, if you put just a little teeny anything of black, it makes it, it screws it all up.
Yep.
So it went too purple. So then I went back towards the light color with this pink. And then finally, I used a little bit of cranberry wine, John Lennon's favorite. Some of y'all will get that. And so I got it like this. And it's passable. It's not great. It's passable. So now I'm going to do this. Oh, and so anyway, so I put it on, and then you can kind of smear it so that it kind of just gets in the part that, so it's not on the top. It's just in the part that is bare wood. So, yeah, I think we'll call it quits. So now I need to do this light blue and see if that brings it all together for us. So we'll see what I can figure out with that. All right, so I did the green. It's a little bit too dark, but I would rather it be too dark than too light. It makes it harder to notice. We're not trying to make it where it's exact, because I don't think I'm capable of it, but we're just trying to get where all of the heavy, heavy wear, where the bare play field disappears. So I did the green instead of the blue. Now I'm going to do the blue for realsies this time. But the green, I shouldn't have to mix like eight colors. That's a sign of an amateur. I should be able to do it with like two colors.
Yeah, two or three, yeah.
Right? So the green was tough, people. It wasn't vivid enough, so I started using this neon stuff. And once you go neon, you can't really go back. I mean, it's like crack.
You got to pour it out. Yeah.
So we did the neon, and then this neon.
That's like a highlighter.
Yeah. And then citron green, which is kind of bright, but it's not quite neon. And then it was too electric, so I tried to dull it down with this. But then it was a little bit off. So a little bit of this to lighten it back up. And then I was like, it's not really a true green, so I used this nice Kelly green. It's like that's a damn green right there. Aren't you Irish?
Yes.
Slightly. There you go.
Yeah.
So, okay. And then this light avocado, just to make it more modern. Did avocados even exist back in the day? Everybody likes avocados now, but, you know.
I mean, they exist. They just weren't common.
Okay. You know, we're almost like Abbott and Costello.
If you say so.
Yeah. I get to be Abbott. You don't know who they are?
I know who they are.
Okay.
I hadn't seen one of their bits in probably 15 years.
All right, so we got the green done. So now let me get out all of my blues. I'm going to mix all the blues together, and it'll probably make it work. All right, so we mixed up a blue. I didn't use all this. I just pulled out all the blues. So it was Bahama Blue. But if you notice, that's too blue. And then I used a little bit of the Citron Green, which was a nice kind of bright green, you know. And mixed the two together back and forth a little bit. Got it pretty good. How's it look from back here? Really, you're not going to get any closer than that, people. I mean, I don't have to show it to you up close. It looks pretty good from back here. The wear was over here, you remember?
Wasn't it up here, too?
Huh?
Wasn't it up here?
No, it was over here, remember?
Nope, I don't.
No. It was right here.
Yep, I see it now.
Remember? You see it?
It's like a streak right there.
No, it was over there. You were right. Yeah. The whole problem is, it's like it's all worn at kind of a different shade. You know what I mean?
We got that little dirt, too, right here, making it more brown.
Yeah, so it's hard to get it because your paint looks new, you know? And then I ran into the same problem there. So it's hard to get it perfect. But, hey, we've hid the wear. The wear is gone, people. So now it's time to clear coat it. So I just use a rattle can. I'm just going, and I use satin because the finish that's on the Playfield right now is kind of satin. So I'm just going to spray this middle area. Then I'm going to spray that area because I re-inked the things. And I'm going to spray over the parts that we touched up because it's acrylic. And if you don't spray it, it will go away. And then after I'm done, we're going to wax it, which will get it all to kind of have the same sheen and look great. So let's throw some clear on it and see how she looks. Okay, folks, we let the clear dry overnight. This is how it turned out. Looks good. What do you think? What do you think? Not bad. I like it. But if you get close, it's off a little bit. Not bad. Much more presentable. I think it's definitely usable now. So I also got in my Mylar things. Let me show you that. I bought them from pinballmods.com. Go check them out. So basically it's like signed material. The guy just cut some and printed some that are just the right size to go around a pop bumper. So I bought some gray ones, some green ones, some orange ones, some yellow ones, and some black ones. I was hoping maybe I'd get lucky on one of those colors and it would match something on the Playfield, but they were all just, they weren't even close really, so I figured the black would be the least intrusive. So I had to put those on, but it's covering up the wear spots and it looks a lot better than the wear did. What do you think, Joe?
Looks great.
Joe says it looks great. I mean, all you people out there complaining about it, I mean, you're not even here, so I can't even hear you right now. So I think it'll be just fine. Okay, so the next thing we have to do is we have to wax everything and then get ready to repopulate the play field.
We'll be right back.
Okay, it's looking a lot better. What do you think? Not bad, really. So we've got a few more cosmetic things to do, but the playfield is pretty much done. I like my black trim rings. I think that looks pretty good, all things considered. The apron came out nice, cleaned up right up, put new cards on it. It's looking pretty good. Okay, so we need to do another video of us troubleshooting it and just seeing what's working, what isn't working. But it's working, you know, it's just not perfectly working. So I don't know what that was. It sounded like a bell's not ringing or something. Or am I getting a... Sounds like the knocker. Did I have the knocker plugged in where the bell is supposed to plug it in? Yeah, you hear it? You hear that? So where the... It looks like where the 10-point bell is supposed to be, they have the knocker plugged in. Yeah, so the bells definitely need some help, people. But she's playing, you know, it's just got issues. So we will do a video where we figure out the issues. So I hope you enjoyed this one. Leave your comments down below. Make sure to give us a thumbs up for taking the trouble to film it for you. And play one-handed. And I hope you enjoyed seeing it all come together. What a pop bumpers are snappy. Remember, they're DC. Game over. All right, yeah, so give us a thumbs up. And we'd like to thank everybody that's been using our Amazon links. Thank you so much for the people that have been doing that. They now work internationally. And guess who's ahead in the race for buying the most stuff on the Amazon links? Canada! Oh, Canada! More people in Canada are buying stuff than any other country. What do you think about that? Kind of surprising. But anyway, we appreciate everybody that's been doing that. It's kind of fun. If you don't know about that, if you click one of the Amazon links below for your country, and then you buy something on Amazon, it gives us a little royalty. So we'd like to thank everybody that's been doing that. Now, what do you think about this ballware that I painted? Remember, there was like a whole track coming down between that fourth and fifth one where you can see the darkened paint there. Remember, it came way on down the playfield? Came out pretty good, I think. I like that. Not perfect, but very nice. It's very, very nice, I think. I'm very proud of it. It's very, very nice. So thank you, everybody, for hanging out with us. And also, go check us out on our brother channel, My Brother Donnie. He is up to almost 600 subscriptions as of this video. So we'll see how high can it go. He's growing a lot faster than I did. I don't know what's up with that. You know, I've got like 25 or 26,000, something like that. He's already up to like 600. I think it took me probably 2 years to get 600, something like that. And he's only been doing it like 4 months. I mean, damn, pretty impressive, really. So we appreciate everybody that's been hanging out over there and watching videos with us. If you don't know, we basically do all kinds of stuff. None of it's arcade related over there. So we're working on, we rebuild a mobile home and things like that. Right now we're doing an old building, but we haven't uploaded any of those yet. But we've been working on our old pickup trucks and stuff. And Donnie's playing with goats. And he did one the other day where he found a big snake and all this kind of crazy stuff. So he has a very eventful life. It's always an adventure. So make sure to check that out. It's called My Brother Donnie, and the link's down below. But thank everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you on the next video where we'll troubleshoot this thing.